The source, Trump campaign manager Kellyanne Conway, talking to us about this. Okay, so you heard what Jim said there. This sort of, it's just, I guess, more straightforward language that we're hearing from Donald Trump today, where he says she has to go to jail. And you have talked about how he is really talking about the process, a special prosecutor, that she should sort of go through the, you know, the process of, I guess, being checked out in a way that your campaign feels that she hasn't been. But he's not talking about the process there. He's saying she has to go to jail.
So, Brianna, I was on an NBC show quoting the NBC.com story, calling it a quip. I just thought that was a clever way of addressing it. But what Donald Trump is doing is he's representing many, many voices across this country who feel incredibly frustrated that yet again there's a different set of rules for somebody named Hillary Clinton than the rest of us. People who have done far less than she's done, imperiling our national security by futzing around with a private server she wasn't allowed to have in the first place, destroying different devices, up to a dozen of them with a hammer, not knowing that the C means confidential when everybody knows that, even those of us who have not been secretaries of state, first ladies of the country, or United States senators. And, you know, FBI Comey left a lot out there. FBI Director Comey left a lot out there. He made sure he called her conduct careless and reckless. And let's be honest, this is an active investigation. In the last 2 weeks, there have been reports that five people involved with this aspect of Hillary Clinton's mendacity have gone and taken the Fifth Amendment. I mean, the last time I wasn't trying to hide something, I wasn't taking the Fifth Amendment, a right to not incriminate myself in front of Congress. So this is an active investigation. Lots of Americans very, very frustrated.
Sure, and I know that they're saying that. We hear them saying that, but this is a presidential candidate saying that. Not only that, it's a presidential candidate who's claiming that he has the better temperament, and yet polls show voters are very convinced he does not. Why is he talking like this if he needs to prove to them that he has a good temperament to be president?
Well, voters in your CNN poll and elsewhere also just can't get over the fact that Hillary Clinton cannot be trusted. So he's
sure
calling
they can't,
that out,
Kellyanne, but he's the one losing in the polls right now.
Right, and when he was winning in the polls, nobody wanted to cover the polling stories. But that aside, if she's got a problem, if she's got a problem with veracity and trustworthiness, and he's calling that out and using any number of examples to illustrate the nagging concerns people have about this woman. I mean, with all of her advantages, Brianna, I'll quote her, why aren't I 50 points ahead? Great question. As she says, why isn't she even at 50% in some of these swing states? She has every advantage. She's outspending us 7-1, 10-1 negative paid advertising.
He's talking about going around the democratic process. I mean, talking about jailing your political opponent is something that
you... No, he's not. He's talking about the result. No, he's not. Literally, and you're just stuck on this one thing when, again, I know I'm on CNN often. I love CNN. I'm just completely mystified why, and it's your show.
But,
you can talk about what you want, but, you know, Americans want to talk about other things. Look at your own polling.
In a court of law, the end result is not determined before a trial. So if you're talking about investigating
this. I said that publicly.
And, well, I'm talking about what your candidate is saying, which is more important than what you are saying about this. He is saying she has to go to jail. He's not talking about she has to stand and be judged. He's saying she has to go to jail.
And? In other words, what are you saying? You're saying that he had to stop and say, and here's how you get to jail. Here's the process. That's completely ridiculous.
Well, it shouldn't be. I mean, he's talking about a predetermined end result here.
Now, he's talking about what a lot of Americans want to know, why the heck this woman wasn't punished at all, and why news outlets like this one think that's okay. Why is a man who took pictures of it inside of a submarine and posted them now facing jail time?
He's saying if he were president, she would be in jail.
You could just keep interrupting me. I'm trying to explain to you, Brianna, that
but
he
I'm talking
is
to you about
the frustrations of millions of Americans. And what the heck has she said about him? Do you want to go through the litany of isms that she accuses him of every single day, as if that's the uplifting, aspirational, optimistic campaign that she has promised and that a lot of Americans would love to hear? Her entire campaign is about Donald Trump. When is the last time you heard her say anything plausible, credible, aspirational, uplifting, and frankly, logical about the issues that voters tell CNN they want to hear about? What is her position on Obamacare? Does she think that she would extend pieces of it? She really flubbed that answer the other night. Her husband told us in a moment of unguarded truth that it's a disaster, especially for small business owners. It's, quote, the craziest thing he's ever seen. We agree with the Trump campaign. Obamacare is a huge. We just don't know what Hillary Clinton would do with it unless we read her website or her book, because nobody asks her. She can just go out there trashing this guy every single day and never have to talk about a single issue.
It seems like your candidate also seems to have an aversion for talking about some of the issues and is definitely tailoring some of his more.
He talked about it today.
He's talking
your
about
own Jason Carroll told you
I'm
that.
Saying he's talking.
Your own Jason Carroll told you that.
Many of the things he says designed to capture people's attention don't have to do with the issues. But I do want to ask you about something that our sources have told us. They say you had a phone call today with Donald Trump supporters in the House who are urging you to stop him or to have him stop attacking House Speaker Paul Ryan and having this schism in the party. He did attack Paul Ryan earlier today. Who's the target here? Should it be Paul Ryan or should it be Hillary Clinton?
So that's a call I have regularly, and we had a great call, actually. I think Donald Trump is at his best when he is talking about the issues, because we own the issue set. We're very much on the side of most Americans on those issues, which is why Hillary Clinton doesn't talk about them. And when he attacks Hillary Clinton's record, I mean, there's so much there you can't even unpack it all in one campaign. She's got a terrible record of Secretary of State. She owns Libya. She owns Benghazi. She should own the Syria, the fake red lines, and what's happening there, which is a complete humanitarian crisis and incredibly sad to all of us, regardless of party affiliation. She owns the Russia reset, where she did that goofy thing walking over and handing somebody some device. She owns a lot of what's wrong with the 94 million people out
but
of
is
the workforce.
He's
right
and
now.
You talk about her having a record. I mean, if Donald Trump is elected, he's going to want to have a record. And part of that, isn't it having a Republican Congress to help him achieve that? Why is he attacking
Absolutely.
The Republican Speaker? Doesn't he want a Republican Congress?
Yes, he does. And yes, he does. And he's doing a lot to help there be one, Brianna, by doing these fundraisers like yesterday.
By attacking the Speaker of the House?
Millions and millions of dollars. And that money goes to the RNC and to
the
committees.
How is attacking the Speaker of the House helpful to him?
You keep saying that. You keep saying he's attacking the Speaker of the House. He said a couple of things, and it's over.
I mean,
in other
come
words,
on, Kellyanne. So, he tweeted
well,
repeatedly.
No,
he called him weak and ineffective.
Then,
okay, well, so, I mean, you want to give him credit
Jim
for
Acosta
not attacking him at one rally.
Appearance, I just heard Jim Acosta say in this last appearance, Donald Trump didn't mention him
So you're
at
saying,
all,
and he's not going to, then,
gonna
is
continue.
He, so is that done? Is he done attacking the House Speaker then?
What he's doing is what he's always done, which is he gives these long
You just
talks,
said he's doing something
minutes,
different.
Somehow,
you're saying he's doing something different by not attacking the speaker.
I can't hear you because you're talking when I am. I'm sorry.
I said you said he's doing what he always does, and I said, but you just said that what Jim Acosta reported, which was that he did not attack Paul Ryan at the second of two events today. To be clear, he did attack Paul Ryan at the earlier event. So what I'm asking you then is that something that we should expect more of? Has he finished with all of the tweets and the comments about Paul Ryan? Is he now turning off the spigot on that?
The spigot? Do you know what the theme of the first speech even was? Has CNN even covered it? Because it had a theme. I bet you don't, because CNN doesn't cover it. It's did he attack somebody? Did he tweet? You're doing a disservice to the American people by not telling them exactly everything fully and fairly of what one of the presidential candidates, actually the only one who goes out and talks to voters on a daily basis about issues.
You're not
even telling them what he's